Hello there, hero. Fancy meeting you in a place like this. You are the one who opened that fascinating portal in the Temple of Hatshepsut, are you not? Let me introduce myself. I am Marinos. I am an explorer of ancient places. I visited many a strange place in this ship of mine. Perhaps I can entice you to go on an adventure with me. You see, your reputation precedes you. And I believe my latest venture is bound to become perilous. I've come across old manuscripts that I have only partially translated. But I'm pretty sure the path to an old kingdom is described within them. A kingdom of unimagined technology and wonder. I'm talking about the fallen realm of Atlantis. One can only begin to imagine what secrets are hidden there. A prize well worth seeking. However, I'm in need of some assistance. You see, so far I've only been able to figure out that the key to deciphering the documents lies in another manuscript, the Journal of Heracles, a functioning sort of a cipher. I believe this text can be found in the city of Gadir, which is said to have been founded by the man himself, far away, west in the peninsula of Iberia. I would ask you to join me in exploring this city and, God's willing, being part of the rediscovery of Atlantis. Think of the fame and fortune that will be ours! I am not a fool. These manuscripts seem genuine. I got them from a trader in Saïs, where the local temple had recently been giving away some of their inventory. Or so he said. It would be nice to get going again. That kraken was a sight to behold, but now that it is dead, there's not much more to see here. On the other hand, it taught me that bringing a monster slayer along might be a good idea. When you are ready to go to Gadir, please speak with my captain. A stout fellow is he, stranger to neither tide nor squall. Here we are, the city of Gadir, rich with dyes and wine. Seems like a nice enough place to settle down in, but we are here for business. As you know, I can't decipher the manuscripts without a certain book, the Journal of Heracles, said to be found somewhere in this area. To learn more about the whereabouts of this diary, I think we should seek out Asmelkar, the current head priest. He's sure to know where the book is, or at least have some clue. He ought to be up by the temple further into the city.
Feeling lucky? You'll be back.
You can't carry any more. Your inventory is full.
May Cairo smile upon you. Come back anytime.
You can't hold any more.
Ah, my favorite whale. I mean,
don't be a stranger.
You can't carry any more.
Fine weapons. Look at them, the best. Check back next week.
Hail, traveler! You gaze upon the chiseled muscularity of the head priest of the cult of Heracles, patron deity of the city. Asmelkart be my name. You search for the journal of Heracles, you say? Ah, you mean the sacred texts. They can be found in the tomb of the legendary king Arganthonios the Old, of course. A wise king ruling the lands before either Greek or Phoenician settlers walked upon these shores. He is said to have been the first disciple of Heracles. I would take you to his grave myself, but, well, to be frank, I am afraid. Our beautiful burial grounds are currently closed to visitors. We're doing some maintenance work. Now bother me no longer. You are disturbing my exercise routine. Okay, you got me. We're having a bit of a ghost problem right now. The dead have grown restless and walk again. Ill omens have been observed. Mayhaps the hound of the underworld has slipped his bonds. What can mere mortals do against such sorcery, I ask you? And to make matters worse, it seems that old King Arganthonios himself has crawled out of his sarcophagus in search of blood, leaving the sacred texts unguarded. You can handle it, you say. I suppose I could let you borrow the sacred texts if you make it, although I doubt it. But I can tell that you've already made up your mind. The necropolis lies farther inland. Just exit the city through the main gate and follow the path. It should be easy enough to find. May Heracles give you strength.
By the favor of the Muses, I will tell of the task that first brought Lord Heracles to our humble city. It was to Erythea that he was sent, just west of here, to steal the red cattle of the giant Geryon as his tenth and final labor. Geryon was a fearsome warrior with the bodies of three men growing from his hips. So he fought with three shields, three spears, and three helmets on his heads. And he would have won their fight if cunning Heracles had not used the poison of the Hydra to bring him down.
Hello there. An explorer, eh? following the call of the great big world. You know, when I was your age, I also could never stay in one place. Gadir is my home now, I suppose. But the truth is that my friend Hiram and I haven't really had one since we first got on that trade ship in Byblos. You have not met him by any chance, have you? He wanted to make a short trip to the cave just outside Gadir, but has been gone for quite a while. Would you mind keeping an eye out for him? Bald guy with a cypress cane?
Thank you. coming here, this wagon held two steers of cedar planks. Thank you.
You return! Ha, my friend, you are wonderful! Now, let's just have a look here. Yes, now I understand it all. The path ahead will be fraught with danger. Good thing I have you. We need to find two artifacts to open the path to Atlantis. One will help us find our way, the other will still the lethal whirlpools that are churning around the island ever since Poseidon struck down the city in anger. The first item is hidden on a small island not too far from here, known as Gaulos. It was once a colony of the Atlanteans. It seems this island had a specific purpose, serving as a religious complex where rites and sacrifices were made. As it happens, I already know a captain who frequents those waters. Just tell him you're with me, and he'll take you along. His ship is moored on the southern coast, just beyond the harbor.
Real, aren't you? I am sorry. Last night I made camp in a nearby cave and I may have smoked a bit too much. I started seeing strange phantoms. Then again, they might have been real. Really hard to tell. I'm too scared. If they are real, they probably have my pipe now. Perhaps you could go have a look? Bring it back to me and I will reward you. The cave is a bit further inland when you start seeing trees.
have no more room. Can't carry anymore. Can't carry anymore. You have no more room. You can't carry, you can't hold anymore. Your inventory is full. You can't carry anymore. You can't carry anymore. You have no more room.
A curious device! This thing is the key to our fortune? And it was guarded by snakes? I can't believe it, but who am I to challenge the Atlanteans? Now, we only need the other artifact. And this one might prove a tad harder to procure, I'm afraid. You see, you need to steal a golden apple from the Garden of the Hesperides. According to the scrolls, offering this fruit to the ocean will appease the violent sea spirits that nest around Atlantis. This should ensure our safe passage. I have already made some arrangements. On the northern pier of the harbor, a ship awaits. It will take you to the north coast of Ethiopia. From there, you must find your way on foot. The garden is said to exist on the western edge of the world, beyond the mountains of Atlas.
Thank you.
carry anymore.
Where are you from, Carthage? Then go back there. Or better yet, all the way back to Canaan. We already see too many of your kind coming here.
What, the garden? Well, yes, it lies to the west. As far west as one can go. But we always give that place a wide berth. It is the end of the world, they say. And the daughters of Nyx are guarding it fiercely. You would be a fool to enter. A fool, you hear me? Though I can tell you more about it.
Thank you.
can't hold any more. Your inventory is full. Your inventory is full. have no more room.
Hello, human. I've been wondering how long it would take until someone finds us here. I am the sole survivor of this once great city of Atlantis, my name long forgotten. Poseidon spared me to bear witness of what has happened here, of how his rage ended our civilization. Many centuries have I existed here in solitude, unable to escape. I was once chief artificer of this place. Many a wonderful thing have I built, too wonderful. We challenged the god of the seas with ships built out of metal that could move without his winds. I've seen oceans and lands beyond your known world, where strange cultures grow. Needless to say, our city became rich, but our leaders were corrupted. Our empire became an affront to the gods, and we were finally punished for our greed. And lately, it seems more trouble is brewing. Evil miscreants have come to defile the ruins of our once beautiful island. How they found their way, I do not know. But they are here. Have you come to stop them, I wonder? The Tritons, the Serpentoids, the Patamoi. A coalition of evil has claimed our once beautiful city. Their commanders bicker and squabble, yet their might is formidable. Something is uniting them, unseen and in the shadows. Its power emanates from the Temple of Poseidon at the heart of Atlantis, but nobody can get inside. All three of their leaders were there when they created the magical seal. Each leader had a part in it, so all of them may be needed to break it. Find the three leaders. Only then can you uncover the temple secrets.
Have no more. You can't carry anymore.
Oh!
can't hold anymore. You can't carry anymore.
Do my eyes deceive me? A living soul in Atlantis! Could this be my blessed day? Hark, traveler! I once was a powerful and respected individual, upholding great influence over this city. But due to unfair and unfortunate unfoldings, I fell into my current state, where I am hitherto unable to execute the simplest tangible task of expelling a couple of belligerent varmints. Be so kind. Make my domain placid and eradicate these mischievous fiends from my estate. Those two misshapes. One creature is bereft of life.
Thank you.
Your inventory is full. Yeah. You can't carry any more.
Stranger, I have seen you helping our cause. Other spirits speak highly of your deeds. But what is it you seek here? Do you wish to learn about the ancient crafts of Atlantis? If so, I could teach you, yes. But alas, I cannot touch anything. So you would have to bring the appropriate tools with you. Which ones? Well, let's see. An artisan blacksmith's anvil, of course, so you can work. A set of mechanical parts of appropriate quality, then a copper coil, and a rod of ferrophilium. That means a piece of iron that pulls other iron objects towards it. Those should be common around the district. Or at least they used to be. Well, you cannot craft anything without materials. Find them all first.
Your inventory is full. Thank you.
Hero, you have done it. I arrived just in time to see the end. What a monster. We knew the cult leaders had some power, but still, who would have thought they would actually be able to summon their dark god? Wait, do you feel that? There is something. Mortal, heed the will of Poseidon. Today a great deed has been done. Evil forces tried to claim Atlantis, but this island is for no one anymore. Neither man nor beast. Only its former inhabitants were to see it. as a reminder of their squandered riches. But at long last, it has once again been a place of noble actions, where nothing but greed and hubris used to reign. So it shall finally be released and sink into the ocean, where it will forever remain hidden from prying eyes. I am eternally thankful for what you have done, Traveler. You'd better leave this place now, lest you sink with it. But my tale ends here. I have played out my part, though long have I waited for it. I am eternally thankful.